I definitely think it is it's a balancing act. We had a unique opportunity with Dartmouth already being in the state to get a home game, which at our spot's very hard. Getting home games here is a challenge. They were in the area, and so we were able to get a home game. Obviously, it's not ideal playing during finals, but you know, our guys have done a pretty good job so far. The thing nowadays is a lot of classes don't actually have final exams, that they finish them up last week. But we do have a number of guys that have finals today, and then a few that have them tomorrow morning, and then they kind of fizzle out for the rest of the week. The good thing is we were on the road this weekend, so we had multiple study halls while we were on the road. And then today we came in and really got after about an hour and 15 minutes just to get out, get moving, get up down the floor a little bit, put some Dartmouth things in moving forward. So nothing too stress required to attend study hall. It's team monitored. If you don't want to go to study hall, all you have to do is make a 3.0. You make a 3.0 GPA and you're kind of on your own. But we monitor our guys very closely, obviously, not only for their academic eligibility purposes, but also just their overall academic success while they're here.
Well, study tables, it depends on what day it is, really. You know, it all depends on, you know, what days you have classes. You know, you have three classes on Monday, you have two classes on Monday. And overall, study tables is about having mental focus, you being mentally locked in, you know, knowing in your mind, like, I got to go study. I may not want to overall, but I have to go and get this work done at the end of the day in order for me to become a better person in the classroom. So when it comes down to study tables, you just gotta have a great mental approach. Overall, I think I have a great mental approach about it, even though sometimes I say to myself, I don't really want to go to study tables or anything like that, but it's all about having that mental approach.
And I think it's for everybody to graduate. We've had a pretty good success rate with that in our 6 years here. And certainly, that's a major emphasis for that too.
Academically,
all four will graduate on time. John Peckinpah may need one additional class in the summer because he changed majors. So three of the four will be graduating in the spring, and then one more class.
It's difficult to do that, you know, just during in the season regularly. Finals week, there's a lot of cramming. Personally, my most of my stuff's over with. So, but I in the you know, the past, it gets very stressful, and we usually don't play during finals week. You know, we just came back from a road trip, and we played again tomorrow, so it does add a lot of stress.
Our basic, you know, academic requirements are pretty straightforward. You're gonna attend class, you're gonna participate in class, and if you don't do what you're supposed to do academically, there's gonna be some pretty stiff consequences. I tell all of the parents of our prospects that we're gonna treat our guys like adults in every aspect of their deal here, except academics. Academically, we're going to stay on them until they prove that they're ready for that responsibility, because it's too big of an opportunity to have your school paid for, to get a great degree like we offer here at IPFW, for us not to stay on top of that and make sure that, you know, all their requirements are fulfilled, so when they leave here, they got an opportunity to be successful.
You know, at first, when going through it at first, you're like, man, this is a lot of stuff, your freshman, sophomore year. But now that I'm a senior looking back at it, I'm like, you know what, my earlier years were easy. This stuff I'm doing now is hard. So it's, you know, it changes. When you go through it, look back at it, you're like, oh, it was easy. What I'm doing now is hard. And I'm sure in a couple of years from now, I'll be like, man, I shouldn't have been playing then.
Right.
But yeah, it gets stressful.
Kind of how we do it is we break up our team. Each one of our staff members has three or four guys that they monitor academically. And they'll be talking with not only the student athlete, but also our academic coordinator multiple times a week. We have a face-to-face meeting with every coach weekly or as needed. And then we're in constant communication with our academic coordinator, who's in constant communication with, you know, with professors, with the people who are at study hall, making sure that we're doing what we're supposed to do in our goal to obviously do.
How does your team handle a trip like last weekend? You went to Omaha, Nebraska. How do you handle that?
Academically or athletically? We didn't handle it well athletically.
Yeah, academically.
But, what we do, for example, we always have study hall on the road. With finals coming, we actually had three study halls this weekend when we were on the road. We got to Omaha early and had a study hall on Friday afternoon, and then we had one Saturday morning, Saturday afternoon, I should say. After our practice, and then when we got back yesterday, we had a third study hall here on campus last night. So we always have study hall on the road, and we had a couple extra this week just because of it was exams when we got back. So I try to always keep pounding them. And
final at 3:30 today.
Oh, do you really?
Yeah, I got a review. I got to go to in a little while, you know. And tomorrow morning, I got a final from 8:30 to 10. And then we're going to the pregame stuff, so it's definitely going to be a lot of time consuming. I actually got a class tonight at 6 after the final.
Wow.
So
yeah. You've got a final and then basketball stuff?
I'm missing a class for the final.
Oh, okay.
So it's a lot going on.
Tomorrow's going to be crazy.
Yeah, it's all crazy. It's definitely a crazy time, but I believe I'm adjusting to it really well. I'm glad that I'm going through it right now, you know, that so I can learn throughout the years. Learning from Trey, Peckinpah, Antoine Boyd, everybody that I'm learning from is telling me just soaking in. You know, these are probably going to be the two hardest years of your whole college career, your freshman and sophomore year. So I'm just definitely getting prepared for it physically and mentally. So
okay.
I'm glad that it's here.
When's the last time you were home?